In this video, we're going to cover partial payments. An example of a partial payment is when the tenant only pays part of the rent. So for example, they may have $1,000 rent, but they only pay $200, and then you apply a partial payment for the $200 out of the $1,000 they owe. And you can either do this in the main accounting table or through the suggested accounting entries. You do it in the main accounting table, usually if you've already processed the rent as late and now it's outstanding. Or if it's in the suggested accounting entries tables, you haven't processed it as late yet, but you're just applying part of a payment before it's late. So we're going to cover both scenarios, and we're going to start with the first one. In this case on the screen, you can see that I've got a transaction that's marked as late. It's red because it's outstanding more than my grace period. In my case, it's 7 days. It's due on July 1st, and now we're at the end of July. And if you go through to the end to the accounting, through the amount, you can see that it's $1,000 is due. So I'm going to select it. And I'm gonna click partial payment. Now you can also view it and click partial payment, but we're gonna do it through the table just because it's quicker. So I'm gonna click partial payment, and I have all the data from the accounting entry. It was due on July 1st. It's gonna say today's date. I can change this to any day I want, but by default it'll use today. I can change the description. Right now it says rent for John. I could also add partial payment if I want, which I will do in this case. I'll say he's paying $200. And I'm not putting in an account right now, just for simplicity, but I can say he gave me a check. And I can say a comment, John will pay the remainder in 3 days. And if I save this, you'll see that now I have two accounting entries. The first one, I'm gonna go over here. I have July 1st, it was due, and he paid a payment on July 26th. And that payment was for $200. Now, he has another $800 outstanding because the rent was a total of $1,000. And so, if you look, he's got $1,000 due, he's paid $200, and he has $800 remaining. Now, if I have a recurring accounting entry, and I haven't processed it yet, it would appear as a suggested accounting entry. And here, it's due on August 1st. So, it's not yet due. That's why it's green. And again, it's $1,000. Now I can say that he's going to apply, and I can do this by opening it, viewing it first, but I'm gonna do it from the table. So I'm gonna say in this case, instead of paying $200, he's paid $400. And I'll say he paid in cash. And I'll say he likes to pay part of it early. And I'm going to apply it. And you'll see that the suggested accounting entry now has been changed. It's still showing the what should be due on the first, but instead of $1,000, he has $600 because the $400 has already been paid. And if I go to my main accounting table over here, you'll see that my August 1st date due, and he paid it on July 26th. I could have changed the date, but I didn't. And then you'll see that this is his $400. So basically, by using the partial payment either here in the main accounting table or in the suggested accounting entries, I can apply a partial payment without having to do all the extra steps manually. I can do it all in an automated fashion.